ever wanted to know what 50 crying babies sounds like? It's like a fun little game. Tick tock, tick tock, when will the crying begin? It's time for everyone's favorite Sims 3 content
that no one asked for,
the speedrun! But not a normal everyday speedrun where you spend 12 minutes befriending a rich Sim so you can bulldoze their house and steal 500,000 simoleons from them. No, that's far too easy for me. I need to elevate myself above the common player and make things 1,000 times harder for myself. I need to spend multiple hours slogging through a game that absolutely hates me and complete a series of entirely arbitrary win conditions for me to feel superior. If you've never seen a speedrun before, let me enlighten you. Traditional speedruns are completing a game or a set goal as fast as possible, sometimes using glitches and sometimes not. There are also meme runs that are completed for the lulz. This speedrun is going to contain a little bit of both. I was never one for boring run-of-the-mill content. Let's play who? Goals! Number 1, become a gardening millionaire. Number 2, plant and harvest every plant type in the game. Number 3, complete all gardening opportunities. And that's it. Sounds easy, right? Well, let's just say I have a few other secret goals to complete too. It wouldn't be a video of mine if it didn't go off the rails at some point. Everyone meet Wesley and Ellis. Wesley and Ellis are our unwitting guinea pigs, cherished participants who will come to no harm, dragon bites notwithstanding. You stick your fingers there, you deserve to get bit. You might notice that Wesley and Ellis aren't exactly human. There are certain things in this game that when used in conjunction with other things absolutely break the game. One such thing is the dragons from the store. OP fails to accurately describe how game breaking they are, and we are going to get 5 of them for free. Now the RNG gods just need to behave and this challenge will be off to a good start, but don't hold your breath. Wesley is a vampire and gets huge skill gains at night. Couple that with the library skill building boost and another store item, the multi-tab, and he's going to be a skill learning machine. Once he's learned his skills, we'll hopefully be ridding him of his vampiric affliction. Having a vampire in a gardening challenge is not the best idea. Either he becomes a burnt pile of ash when you aren't looking, or he stands in the corner staring at the wall until it's nighttime and he becomes useful again. Neither are particularly helpful in a speedrun. Ellis, on the other hand, is extremely helpful in his current form. Not only can he handle daylight hours, but his fairy power of bloom will come in handy down the line. So let's get this party started. 3, 2, 1. All right, first step, gardening skill. So Wesley is going to do his best impression of a statue and not die. And Ellis is off to grab us some free dragon eggs. Our lot is strategically placed in the middle of everything we need, so it's just a quick trip to the graveyard and the really weird basement under the library, and we have 5 free dragon eggs. You are probably wondering why I have 6 elixir stores in the game, and that is me trying to cheat the system. I thought maybe each one would have its own separate list of items to buy, but it turns out they all have the same thing. Womp womp. It would have saved us considerable time not needing to do the first lottery round, but I guess it's more fun this way. Wesley is off to get a job for no real reason. Honestly, I just wanted something else to drive myself crazy trying to complete. While Wesley gets his skill on, Ellis is off to the elixir store to check out the wares. I couldn't have the one thing I needed first try, could I? No. But he did grab a couple supernatural items we can plant. Now comes the fun part, setting up these dragons. If you aren't familiar with the dragons, they will randomly hatch into 1 of 4 types. Each one has a special skill and abilities, so some are more desirable than others. Sorry, purple dragon. We need 2 of either red or black and 2 green. Ultimately, we need 2 of each, but right now red and black are the most important, followed by green. And now starts the same animation loop over and over and over and over. Basically, you can manipulate which dragon you get with certain options. It isn't 100% foolproof, but the more you talk to it, the more chance you have of getting what you want. So I'm gonna spare you the pain of watching the same thing for the next 10 minutes and we'll check on Wesley. Are you still alive? Good job. All right, the moment of truth. 3 reds, 1 black, and a purple. That's disappointing. I set up at least 2 for green, so we get to start this whole process all over again with eggs I actually have to pay for this time. The only good thing about this whole thing is the eggs cost 359 simoleons and the hatched dragons sell for 1,000. Ugh, more Kasubunami. You guys do not know how lucky you are that this is getting edited out. Now that it's nighttime, Wesley can come home and get recharged for another rousing round of learn at the library. You want to see just how OP these dragons are? Tired. Who's tired? Each dragon is focused on 2 different needs. You might be wondering how 4 dragons work on 6 needs. There's some overlap. Red and black both cover energy. Black also covers hunger, and red covers hygiene. Purple covers social and fun, the least important in my opinion. Green covers hunger and bladder. Green also has a superpower we're going to exploit the heck out of later. It was at this point I realized all my cooing at my dragons meant I hadn't gone to the store yet, and if I didn't want Wesley to die of hunger, I had to get him some plasma fruit stat. I do have a contingency backup plan, the mini fridge with the plasma orange juice, but feeding him real food takes way too long. It is faster to shove a plasma fruit in his pie hole. This definitely makes me feel like Sonic. Oh, joy of joys, the first gardening portion of this speedrun. Now you're going to probably see 0.0001% of the gardening because honestly, it's boring. However, that doesn't mean I didn't sit through all this nonsense. So maybe toss your girl a thumbs up or comment. I did have to sit through this for almost 11 hours. Okay, game, I'm going to level with you. I need you to stop giving me other colored dragons when I'm specifically setting you up for green ones. Please, don't make me keep doing Kasubunami all night. So remember that stuff works together to break the game? Well, the growth station and the sunflowers come together to absolutely destroy gardening. Have enough money and you can have never-ending harvest. If that wasn't great enough, combine that with the green dragon and you don't even have to harvest the plants. The little guy will do it for you. However, we need to get a green dragon first. Come on, game, work with me. Finally, only took 25 minutes of hatching eggs to get one. If you are wondering what I'm planting all red berry beans right now. You might be thinking, why aren't you planting more? You want to get to $1 million as fast as possible, right? Well, red berry beans aren't cheap to buy in the first place, so you need a lot of money to buy them. Second, I don't want to plant too many because more plants means more impact on the stability of the game. Once you start getting around 300 red berry beans sitting on the plants at any given time, the performance slows to a snail's pace or comes to an absolute standstill when using the grow station and harvesting by dragon. Trust me, patience is key when working with plants. I've had stacks of produce over 1,000 outright crash my game in the past. This isn't a speedrun to get the game to crash the fastest, so moderation is key. Enough to get some cash flow, but not enough to end the speedrun prematurely. You learn these things when you have more than 10,000 hours in the game, especially if every single family has a gardener at some point. If you love a game, you learn to live with the quirks. So, if you aren't going to fill up all those grow stations, why are they there? They do something special that we're going to take advantage of. They spit out seeds for you to collect, and we will need a lot of those seeds later. And there we go, level 10 gardening and a little over 36 hours in game time. I probably could have gotten it done faster if I'd noticed he didn't have his tabcast running or he had stopped reading sooner, but this is just for fun.
I'm not gonna obsess.
Anyway, you would think Wesley is done, but nope. Set your butt down and get back to work. We're doing the science skill now. Why science? Well, there is one plant type that can only be spliced into existence, and we'll need high science skill to make the tedium go a little bit faster. So, it's been a bit, and we've moved on to fishing with Ellis. Now, you're probably wondering why the heck we are fishing in a gardening challenge, and all I have to say is have patience. My entire plan will be explained to you in due time. It's Tuesday night, and we have 75 grand to our name. Time for the next phase of gardening. Now, this is where things are going to get a little bit laggy. We are going to head to the store and buy every single plant available there, plus a few edible things for some Frankenstein looking plants we'll plant later. After our fruit and veggie buying spree, we have our first lottery situation. What I found in my extensive hours invested into this game is that certain stores like the Elixir store have a never ending supply of items for sale. If you completely wipe out the store, a new set of items will replenish the stock. So how much money do you think I'm going to have to spend to find the one item I need? Well, since restocks are random and there are lots of items available, it really depends on how kind the RNG gods want to be. Here's hoping that I don't bankrupt us in the process. Yes, after 10,000 years, we got the item I needed. I gave up last night after spending 25,000 simoleons, and what do you know, it shows up within 2 rounds the next day. Yes, I just spent around 30,000 simoleons to change him from a vampire to a human after specifically making him a vampire in Kaz. It will all make sense, trust me. Okay, after many hours planting plants and keeping track of which ones I planted, we are ready for the next phase. Real talk, if I ever do this again, I can save so much time and headache if I had an alphabetical list of plants. The next phase was the second lottery event that wasn't. I got super lucky and found everything I needed and didn't have to buy out all the produce to reset the carts. I am super grateful for this because the carts are really expensive. I need more useless produce in my inventory like another hole in the head, so I am going to thank my lucky stars for this. Let's talk opportunities. I'm gonna be real transparent here. I am using a mod to get the opportunities to fire off. A common complaint since Into the Future came out is that opportunities were broken somewhere in the process of making that pack. Here are the gardening opportunities outlined by the game. All except the three special ones are basically take this produce to this person. I did all of them and they were super easy to finish when you have an inventory full of every single piece of produce known to man. After completing the special opportunity Uncommonly Good, we get another opportunity in this chain of challenges called Outstandingly Rare, which tasks us with planting cheese. Yes, you heard that right. We are planting cheese and a bunch of other interesting items. The next opportunity in this quest chain is the Omnificent Plant, and it tasks us with planting steak. Yes, we are planting beef in the ground. This is surprisingly not the weirdest thing to come from a plant that we will see in this speedrun. Okay, it's time to pack our bags and head to China. What? We need to get a growing item from China, so the only way to do that is to actually go to China. We'll only be spending about 2.5 seconds in China, long enough to buy the item we need, then we're jetting back to Dragon Valley. I think I spend more time in loading screens than I actually do in China. I had no idea that the drop-off spot was way out there in the boonies. That's fun. I usually play in worlds that have more roads, so it's super quick to get home, but more time lost as these guys find the road. What does fishing, China, and the store have in common? Plants, silly! If you are confused, let me explain. Ellis got to level 10 fishing so he could catch a death fish. We went to China to buy a bunch of copies of the most expensive book in the game. We also bought a rubber ducky when we were at the store. All of these things can be planted and harvested. I don't know if that explanation helps or makes you more confused. When we completed the Omnificent Plant opportunity, we got some seeds. These were Omniplant seeds, and once planted and matured, you can feed a lot of different things to them and it will duplicate them. Now's the moment when I realized that I forgot about Ellis's lifetime wish and I've basically done nothing to complete his. Wesley had Perfect Garden and we had that finished within the first few hours. Here we are, halfway done, and I'm staring at 100 blooms for Ellis. He's also not level 10 in his fairy magic, so this could take a while. And then, just like that, we are 8 hours into the run and it's time to head to the future. I'm hoping that everything survives us going into the future, so fingers crossed as we enter the portal that when we come back, everything will be okay. Now, we are in the future for one reason and one reason only, to get crystal plant flowers. Now, you could hang out in the future until a crystal plant crops up, or you can head to your friendly neighborhood bot dealer and play roulette until you get them. Obviously, with over 1 million in cash, I'm gonna play the lottery and see how long it takes to get what we want. Well, the damage isn't too bad, only 14,000 simoleons this time. Let's head home and finish this speedrun. Uh-oh, that's not good. Yeah, I think our dragons are glitched, and that really sucks after what happened earlier in Ellis's inventory. Uncommon, rare, and special seeds stack, but when you identify the seeds, you have a stack of mismatched seeds. This can glitch out your inventory, so I decided in my infinite wisdom to use the power of mods to remove the glitched seeds from Ellis's inventory, and the game emptied his inventory completely, and I lost a whole set of dragons. No, I am not bitter, I'm just really mad. So, we dropped Wesley's dragons on the ground to share. Well, now they are doing their best T-pose impression, and I think they are broken. This is not good. So let's see if I can fix them. Crisis averted. Alright, it's finally time for the finale! Excuse me? What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to finish up a speedrun over here, and you are messing up my carefully planned finale. Honestly, the nerve of some people. Wesley has been diligently working on the science machine for hours to make us splice seeds. A small percentage of them become forbidden fruit, and you know what that means. Wesley made us 51 forbidden fruit, and we've planted them all. They are all ready to harvest, and that means there will be 50 babies entering this household, and one fruit for later. So here's the $1 million question. Will we get all 50 babies, or will the game crash? Time ends if the game crashes, or when all 50 babies scream their lungs out. Let the harvesting begin! 49 and 50! There! All the babies have been born, and the last fruit is going to Wesley. Fun fact, I've never played a plant sim before, so this is a first. Wow, look at him! Love the look! Somewhere between seaweed and bacon. And here are all the babies. I think we have a few more boys than girls. I'm really not sure though. There are so many, and I figured my game would crash way before we got to this point. I wanted to go out with a bang, but apparently we're going out with a scream. And there is the shriek to signal the speedrun is over! I think this is simultaneously the most amazing thing I've ever created, and also the most cursed. How do you top this?